Sprouting a kid, I'll do a DNA test, it's not mine. And here we all are with me dog Spud in studio, which pops out of the ground like magic. We're all here to make the best telly show on telly. What is that telly show that's on telly? Celebrity Juice on telly. First up is Holly Willoughby. Who's on your team?
Well, on my right, I've got Mr. Frosty Knickers himself. It's Jason Gardner. On my left, I've got a singer who has the lot. It's the gorgeous Pixie Lott.
You have got the lot. You have got the best legs in music, honestly. I think I've tweeted that before. Just, you've got wicked legs.
Thank you, so do you.
OK, let's meet our other team captain who's got disgusting legs. It's Fern Cotton. Who's on your team?
You look like a dickhead.
My team, all right. For Lee Ryan!
Ben, who else is on your goddamn team?
I have got Irish boy band royalty, Cian Egan!
Jason, yeah. Jason, hello.
Hello.
It was the final Dancing on Icicles this weekend.
Yeah.
Are you sad it's all over?
Sure. I mean, you know, it was a big part of our life for 9 years.
You were on the show since 2006.
Yep.
Except for the year they replaced you with Louis Spence.
That's right.
And what's that like?
It was good. I mean, I
were
wanted
friends?
To go. Yeah, we're really good mates. You know, like, Louis is one of my oldest
friends.
Did
like phone you and go... You know? So what are you going to do now that you're unemployed?
Well, I'm available for whatever.
What about, like, TV presenting?
Well, I'll give it a go. Why? Yeah. You got a job?
Well, why don't you do the opening for this show? Let's see how good you are at presenting.
At what? This show?
Who wants to see Jason Gardner present Celebrity Juice? Go to top of steps, chat up some women, or men, whatever.
Okay.
You just be me, but not with my voice, your voice.
Oh,
get down,
bouncer,
you flaming bastard, all that shit, yeah.
So what, I'll go up there?
Yeah, yeah, right up there.
Are you going to come sit next to me?
Yeah.
Okay.
What is that telly show that's on telly? Celebrity Juice on telly.
Celebrity Juice! All right. Let's meet our team captains. First, she's got the best bangers in the business. It's Holly Willoughby!
Thank you, thank you.
Next, she looks like a boy in drag.
Oh, don't you fucking stop!
Fern Cotton! Who's on your team?
On my right, he's ginger and a wanker. It's Keith.
Oh, come on, they're turning off, man. They're fucking turning over. They're turning over. They're going to turn over, man. Jason Gardner, everyone! Hey, it's only the king of the jungle. It's Cian Egan! Egan,
you.
Have you had a drink?
I had one or two.
two beers in the dressing room.
Welcome back to Celebrity Juice.
Thank you for having me back.
You were crowned King of the Jungle last year on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. What was it like in Jungle?
It was great. I really enjoyed it, actually.
Did you really, though?
Yeah.
Would you do it again?
I would, actually, yeah.
What was the hardest bit in the jungle?
Honestly, and as much as...
your wife?
And my little boy, absolutely, yeah. Being away from my wife and my little
boy. And
what
about not wanking?
No, it's really funny, right? Your sex drive switches off automatically in there. I don't know why, right? And it's actually in the rules that masturbating is against the rules. And if you're caught masturbating in the jungle, you get kicked out.
Well, what do you think happened to Lee when he was at Big Brother house?
You know, I mean, I just knew that was coming.
Kitty, kitty, kitty! And your new album. And the single that's out now is called Home. Whose voice are you miming on this then? Your own voice.
My own voice.
In homage to you, we've come up with a little game called Key and He or Key Ain't He. And we're gonna play it throughout the show, which is a good chance for you to win a Brucey bonus point.
Okay.
And whenever you hear a Westlife song, come
right.
on,
yeah.
That's when we will just rush into it and play the game.
Okay.
Pixie.
Yeah.
Is Pixie your real name?
No, it's not. No.
I'm flying without.
For the first challenge in the game, we're calling Key and He or Key Ain't He. Come on, let's do the first challenge.
Okay.
So, Kian.
Yes.
Kian, you eat a banana.
I can't eat a banana.
Well, this should be a simple challenge for you, because all I'm going to do is ask you to eat a banana, yeah?
Okay.
Let's get a banana. Some bananas. Just eat a banana.
You went in the jungle and ate assholes.
That's what I'm saying.
Banana.
This should be simple.
Okay. Or is that all I've got to do?
No. I want to see if Key and He eat a banana through a stocking.
Oh!
Hang that on your head and then try and eat the banana through
it. Oh, you go for the stocking.
Key and He or Key
Ain't
He?
The banana was going in.
Nice.
Jesus Christ.
Good luck.
Some people at home would dream of doing. Right, let's see if Key and He or Key Ain't He eat a banana for
well,
a stocking.
It's only for because we're playing an actual game and I want to win a point for
a point for your team,
you're
isn't
right.
it? Come on. Oh, it's Sam the Monkey. Go. Come on, eat it, not spit it out. Come.
What a great game.
Chew it. Sit down. Jason's not bothered, he's seen this enough times, boy, around. Put this stocking on your head, eat that fucking banana.
Every Saturday night.
Oh, yeah, don't have to eat that, it's been on floor, dirty
no,
boy.
No. Okay.
Oh, there's the Paxton. Yes. Are you finished? Yes. Yes!
You guys get up to at home.
Yeah. Pixie.
Yeah.
You're not really called Pixie.
I've been called it since I was born as a nickname.
Yeah.
And so it's not like a stage name. I was called it when I was born, but it's not on my birth certificate.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
What's your real name?
You have to guess what it is.
Ian.
Do I look like an Ian?
Do you want to tell us?
Yeah, okay. It's Victoria.
Victoria?
Yeah, do you think that suits me more than Ian?
Is it Victoria Lott?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It is, yeah.
And why did they call you Pixie? Are we little?
Yeah, I was really small. I was
stand
so mature.
Up. Stand up. Right,
I'm not that small anymore, by the way.
Right, everyone at home, I'm about 6'1".
I'm Pixie. Not small anymore. It changed.
Just want you to stand up so you get a good shot of your legs. Get the legs. You've got a new song.
I do.
Here it is. It's called Nasty.
Yes.
What's the message?
The message is, well, it's called Nasty, but it's not nasty as in not
him.
Very nice, as in, yeah. Exactly, you got it. It's not nasty as in his kind of vibe.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's nasty as in, like, a bit naughty, like a little bit cheeky.
Oh, like in the ass, but you say, sorry, I didn't.
a mistake. It's a mistake. Oh, sorry! Sorry!
That's not
right. You're in the dark. A hole's a hole, innit? I don't know. Lee Ryan, it's lovely to have you on the show. House Tricks.
Yeah, sweet.
You love life's good right now?
Yeah, I suppose so, yeah.
Have you got a girlfriend at the moment?
Yeah.
What's her name?
Jasmine.
Oh, you're still seeing Jasmine? Yeah. So it's proper then?
Well, yeah, but she's back in LA at the moment, so yeah. I'm just gonna see what happens.
Has she got a boyfriend over there? But she's definitely gone to LA.
Yeah,
properly.
She's
why don't you phone Casey then?
It was hard. It was a difficult situation because I didn't want to hurt anyone.
Yeah, but the trouble is, Lee, you did. That's the problem.
Why?
I know that you didn't want to, but you did. Because what you did is you went for one and sort of led her out. And
we're on this morning. I love it.
I don't think it's because you're bad.
No,
or
because
nasty
everyone's
or
acting like I boil small kittens for a living.
Do you speak to Casey still?
No, she deleted me off Twitter.
Did you? Oh, here we go. Carry this Westlife CD from hither to this bin here.
Yeah.
That's easy, innit?
Except
I'm gonna move you a bit further. That's a bit harder, innit?
It's a bit further.
So relay it back to me what you're gonna
do. I've got to carry that CD from hither.
Yeah, hither.
To the bin.
Yes, yes. But you didn't mention that you've got to carry it with your ass. Yeah. So when you hear you raise me up, I want you to raise it up into your crack. You've got as long as the chorus, so you raise me up.
Tell me when.
When you hear you raise me up, you raise it up.
Okay.
You raise me up.
No, I'm not.
Oh, I actually already have a certain amount of time.
He can't.
No, he can't. Give me another go. One more go.
Can I give him another go?
Go again. This is
the way. Stop it! You ready? Three, two, one. Okay, after all those fun and frolics and tiny bollocks, it's time for the VT round. Pixie, what does VT stand for?
Video tape.
That's correct. Let's run it and see what it's all about.
For centuries, I have scoured the earth and gathered together the four greatest superheroes of our time. Living hidden amongst us as celebrities, they are Captain Cosmetic, Oblivion, General Blue Tit, and the Special One. Together,
we are the Fantastic Four.
And who am I?
I am Professor Fantastic.
Okay, this is how it's going to work. The Fantastic Four are a collection of superheroes. Each week, one of them will be eliminated from the realm of that superhero clan. So who's going to get knocked out first?
So this is a super intelligence test.
Super intelligence test.
Is this like a trick question? Because Joey Essex is in that lineup.
I think it might be Anthony.
Do you?
Yes.
We're going to go Captain Blue Tit.
Captain Blue Tit?
Yeah.
General Blue Tit.
General Blue Tit.
General Blue Tit. Fern's team, which superheroes can be eliminated?
I don't know if you guys saw this on Celebrity Juice, but Joey Essex thought that Wales was next door to Russia.
Yeah.
He's the loveliest guy.
He is lovely.
But he is thick as shit.
I have to stick up for Joey in this. I think it's going to be Captain Cosmetic or maybe
Blue tits.
Should we go cosmetic? Blue tits as well, blue let's go cosmetic, Captain Cosmetic.
Yeah, I think.
So let's find out who we picked out. This is the super intelligence test. Oh.
You join me here in the Banktastic Four lair, where I'm joined by my Banktastic counterparts. Okay, the first category is animals. I make love to a cat.
Giraffe.
Dog.
Iguana.
Lizard.
Leopard.
Donkey.
Alpaca.
Cow.
Lion.
Dog.
I was struggling then. I was thinking frogs and all that. That ain't an animal, is it?
What is it? Is it? Is it an furniture?
It's an amphibian.
It's an animal, isn't it, really, as well, so, still.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It is.
Captain Cosmetic, let's start with you, and the category is biscuits. Biscuits.
Digestive.
Jaffa cakes.
Hobnobs.
Milk chocolate.
Fuck.
Yes!
Yes, Jerry! Yes, Jerry! I'm so happy for you.
OK, let's go on to the next category. Continents.
What's a continent?
Africa.
Europe.
Asia.
England. What are you wrong? Are you laughing at me?
I need to go to the toilet.
God's sake, mate.
OK, the final category is members of the Beatles. You said he looks like...
John.
Paul.
Ringo.
Michael.
Hold on.
You don't know the Beatles?
No, I do know who they are, but I would not know any of their names. I really
not one of them.
I don't know them.
Name one. They've just named loads of them.
Ashley.
Ashley. Ashley from the Beatles. What was he? Dancer at back. One that's still alive and has got a daughter was a fashion designer.
Nicole.
No.
Done the Jubilee with Gary Barlow.
I don't know who he is.
Sort of talks like that.
I can't be the only person in the world who don't know.
I think you fucking are.
So I can announce that the Banktastic superhero that would be eliminated from the Banktastic Four this week is none other than...
Just sort of no attention.
..is the special one.
Oh, fine.
Good night, guys.
Good night, John.
Look.
Later.
See that special?
It's a Liberty, man.
Yeah, it's Liberty. It's a big shop.
See that, John.
To either teams, and the scores at the end of that round are surety! We're gonna go to an ad break now. I'm off for a crap. Please come back! Ta-da! Coming up after break.
It's not burned.
Bloody Hell magazine, cut into different categories. Our teams will choose a category, then I will ask them a question regarding that category. Choosing a category first up is Fern's team to choose a category.
Can we have head-to-head, please, Keith?
You've chosen head-to-head.
Head-to-head.
It's Deborah Jordy Shaw! Why, aye, Peg, how's it going, like?
Can he, aye?
Aye! Have you gone down the tune? Get on your coat. Gaz, you've got a book out now, yeah? Your autobiography, Gaz and My Parsnip. What's the parsnip reference to?
Someone nicknamed me Dick, a parsnip, for some random reason.
Is it shaped like a parsnip?
For some reason, it's the most ugly vegetable there is, but that was the nickname given.
And it tastes pretty rank as well, doesn't it?
You've got a dick shaped like a parsnip.
That one, though.
Have you got a right big bell end? Well, when, I tell you, when I was at school, they used to call me butternut squash. Gaz, everyone! OK, so, Fern, you chose Ed to Ed. In this round, two panellists will be going Ed to Ed, hence the title Ed to Ed, in a series of challenges. So let's play Head to Head. OK, out of the head-to-head box. Let's see who's inside. Oh, look what it is. It's Kieran Egan and Pixie Lott.
Hello there. How you
so
doing,
you'll be going head-to-head. Let's see what you'll be doing.
Dun, dun, dun.
So, as you can see, we've both we've got your singles here. What I want you to do is try and get your CD in the portable CD player using only your mouth. The person who gets it in, well, their track will be played at the end of the show. It's a good plug for your disc.
Yes.
Your disc, your CD. You'll go on the klaxon, it's as simple as peas. There's the klaxon! Oh, oh, look at Kingo, look at that son. Your wife's a lucky lass. Oh, look at Pixie. Look at that, go on, Pixie. Go on, get your tongue stuck in. There, don't put the cover in, put the disc in.
Press play.
Okay.
How did you get it on it?
Hold it, hey, Pixie, who needs hands?
Yeah. 10 minutes, oh. Upside down.
Let's play.
The winner and the point goes to Pixie Lott. Okay, let's see who's going to be going head to head now. Who is it? Okay, ready for your challenge?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what it is.
I'm hoping it's ice cream. Bread. Such good special effects on this show, by the way. Two more drama. Smoke.
What you've got to do is, it's simple, you just want to suck the, because of legal reasons, I can't say what it is.
Chocolatey ball.
The honeycomb chocolate-covered
ball.
I'm going to pop it in there, the chocolate ball, and you have to suck it.
Oh, my God.
The winner will be the person who sucks the most balls.
Holly's so going to win this.
Based
on
what?
She's great at sucking balls.
You ready? So, obviously, you've paused that now, taken a picture of it, and you can Photoshop a penis into the mouth, can't you?
No.
They're rolling down!
Hold on. Go eat them!
Don't point at me by mouth.
What are you doing, taking your clothes off? Come on, you're going to win this. Go, keep them! You've got two, you dickhead! Keep them! Replay, get your tissues.
Oh no. Oh God.
Fern is the winner.
Oh, I'd just like to say thank you for playing head to head.
Oh, well, thank you.
Thank you.
And thanks for you at home watching.
Head to head, all best. Scores at the end of that round are shitting! Yes! They love the scores, Jason,
yeah.
Jason, I tell you what, over the years you've given some people some shit, haven't you?
Apparently, yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to read you some of your quotes from the show.
Okay.
And I want you to tell me who you were talking about.
Oh, okay.
Yeah? For everyone you get right, you'll get a point.
Oh.
Yep. Here's the first one. You look like you've crapped yourself.
Was that Todd Carty?
That's correct.
Oh, yes, oh, good. Good. Yeah.
If your opinion mattered, you'd still be on the panel.
Oh. That was oh,
That was, yeah.
If your opinion mattered, you'd still be on the panel.
That'd be Karen Barber.
Correct. You fell out with her, didn't you?
We did, over that particular... Well, but that was real.
Well,
that
for
was,
a period of time, like a couple of years or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. You look like fecal matter that won't flush.
That's a good one. I like that one.
That was Sharon Davis.
I bet you what it's doing.
That's though. Correct. Sharon Davis, yeah. OK, our next round is called Flappy Discs. Now, when we finished the last series of Celebrity Juice, I was busy at home with my different head on. I sort of like to invent things. And I've invented a new games console to rival all the other game consoles out there. It's called the Xbox One. It's made out of recycled Xboxes. Right. But anyway, I'm really excited because I'm gonna launch it here on Celebrity Juice. So come with me now as we play Flappy Discs! So here we are, we're playing Flappy Discs. I'm here with Jason Gardner. You well?
I'm very well.
Good, good. Let me tell you about the peripherals. What I've done, I've hooked it up to an 180-inch plasma screen. It's not 3D, no. It's not 4D, it is 5D. It's like virtual reality. You can get in there and like touch them and stuff. What you've got to do is pick up these Flappy Discs,
right,
and throw them at the birds. Because a lot of games now are all birds out there, so we've got some vexed birds. These birds are vexed. You've got to knock the birds off their heads for a point for your team. Yeah?
OK.
It's simple, isn't it?
Hey, Keith, before we get into this, there's a spare hat here, actually. Who thinks that maybe Keith should put that on?
Oh, fuck it, go on, then.
One, here you go. You should probably have the cock one, to be fair, but you're...
Oh, thanks, sir. You're very... I think I've done it, yeah.
You got it.
Yeah, you've done it there.
I ain't got a cock.
Right.
What did I do? I'm scared.
When you hear the computer power up, throw the floppy disk.
I'll try.
Oh, God.
Jason, you got all the vex birds off their heads then. That's 4 points. That's incredible, isn't it? Join us after the break when we'll be going to the expert level, the revenge level. See you after break. Coming up after break, Karen Barber. Throw it as hard as you can. And if you go lower down and get his middle bits, that's okay. Welcome back to Celebrity Juice. We're still playing Flappy Discs. This is the expert level, the revenge level. You were throwing it quite hard, weren't you?
Well, I had to knock them off, didn't I?
It's an expert level, so we need an expert thrower to try and get that little tiny bird off your head, yeah? Please welcome the expert thrower, Karen Barber! Karen, can you remember back in the day when he was having his little beef?
Which one?
What did you say?
I can't remember.
If your opinion mattered, you'd still be on the panel. Can you remember the anger in your soul when he said that?
I just stood between you both.
I know.
It was awful.
I know.
Are you over it now, aren't you?
Maybe.
So what you've got to do is pick up the flappy disc and try and get the tiny bird off his head, yeah?
OK.
And throw it as hard as you can.
I bet I do.
Yeah. And if you go lower down and get his middle bits, that's OK. Just because he's going to be moving back and forward. You're obviously going to hit his willy now and again, aren't
By mistake.
Bastard.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah. So when you hear the computer power up, get ready to throw the flappy disk.
You just tell me when to go.
Yeah. Go, 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 go. Point for Bernstein.
I'm rushing. Hang on. Oh. That side.
She's there. Oh. Feel good?
I wish you felt great.
Quick fire buzzer round. OK, buzzing if you know the answer. If you don't know the answer, be a chancer. First question. What is Simon Cowell doing here? Ferns team!
Modelling for page 3.
Holly Willoughby's team!
Holly's team?
Is he about to breastfeed?
No, that's incorrect.
Holly Willoughby's team!
Holly's team?
He's walking his dog, his girlfriend and his baby from the beach.
That's correct. What wow. part of Pixie Lott is this?
Pixie.
Oh my gosh, what the hell? That is not a part of me, surely.
What is that?
Holly Willoughby's team.
Hollaby's team.
Is it like that bit of her elbow that looks like
that
a
bit of
my elbow? Looks a bit like that.
Awry. I think it's awry.
Awry?
Yeah, because it looks like mascara. It could be mascara in the crease.
Let's see if it's awry. That's a rampant!
Oh, my God!
Wait for your team if you can touch this toaster! That's the end of this week's Celebrity Juice. I can tell you the winning team is... It's Holly's team! I was Keith Lemon. If I don't see you for a week, I'll see you for a window. Let's dance and get nasty!
It's Dad's Next on ITV2. David and Crawford are going all teenage boys on us. Years of maturity and wisdom go out the window in an instant. All it takes is one lady to turn up in the office and all hell breaks loose.